Yes, coordinate geometry I will not be teaching you today. Today I will be teaching you differential equations.
X is 2 or 3? X is.
Up to third exercise we have already solved the questions.
Yeah,
we have solved this. Okay, so we will be going for exercise 9.4 today.
Yeah, it's solved.
Differential equations. So we will be solving some of the questions from exercise 9.4. Okay, so the very first question, what it is given to us as dy by dx is equal to 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x. Right? So now we need to solve now. Now we have come earlier in, you can say, 9.3 exercise, what we have seen, we have framed the differential equation.
Yes.
We framed the differential equation. Before that, in exercise 9.2, we found out that whether this particular solution, it is a expression is a solution of this particular differential equation or not. We understood that what actually is a general solution and what actually is a particular solution. Here also, in some of the cases, we will be finding particular solution. Okay. Particular solution means there will not be any constants. In general solution, there will be constant, right? Okay. So we framed in previous exercise by removing constants, arbitrary constants, we framed differential equation. Now, if differential equation is given to us, then how we will be solving that differential equation? That particular part will be going on. Okay. So in this exercise 9.4, we are going to solve some of the questions. Now, suppose it is there. So you can write as, so you will be, you need to separate it, dy portion you need to separate, dx portion you need to separate.
But both are dx or cos x.
So here, actually, the variable 1 plus cos x, here both is there. So this dx will come this side.
Yeah.
Now we need to solve it.
Yes, sir.
So in solving, further we will be going for that when next one will be there, homogeneous equation. In that homogeneous equation, we will be finding little difficulty.
Okay.
No problem. And then next exercise, it will be some particular different pattern will be there in which integrating factor we need to find.
Okay.
So that will be the last exercise of this differential equation. Okay. For us, in 12th standard, we need to solve only first order differential equation.
Okay.
We are not going for second order and third order, which you will be studying when you will be joining any engineering field. Then you will be able to study particularly second order, third order, how you can solve it. Right? Okay. So now if we want to solve this equation, so we need to integrate it.
Yes.
So integration both sides. So we will be writing as integrating both sides. We get. So integration of dy is giving you 1 minus cos x by 1 plus cos x. Dx. So now it has become an integral.
Yes.
Normal integral. Okay. So in this normal integral, we will be finding out now. So we have to integrate by utilizing some of the tactics now. So we know the formula of 1 minus cos x and 1 plus cos x. Yes. So it is giving to us 2 sine square x by 2. X by 2.
Yes.
Then here 2.
Cos
square x by 2 dx.
Right?
So 2 2 will get cancelled. So y is equal to 10 square x by 2 dx. Okay, what will be writing for that?
1 minus.
Can we write that second square x by 2 minus 1? Yes, very good. Dx. So now it has become easy for solving?
It is not 1 minus 6 by 2.
Okay. So second square x by 2 minus 1, correct? Second square x by 2 minus 1 will be giving you 10 square x by 2. Second square x by 2 will be there. Second square x by 2 is what? 1 by cos square x by 2 minus 1?
Yeah.
So this is giving you 1 minus cos
square
x by 2 by cos square x by 2. This is sine square x by 2 by cos square x by 2. Correct? Okay. So this. Now it has become easy for us. So this will become y is equal to. So second square x by 2. Please tell me. 10 x by 2. So 10 x by 2. Again, 1 by 2 is there, na, here along with this. So, divided by?
1 by 2.
Understand it? Okay, good. Minus x plus c. Plus c?
Plus c.
So, this will be giving you y is equal to 2 times 10x by 2 minus x plus c. So, compulsorily here in this solution plus c will be there.
So, it's a general solution.
Yes, it is general solution. It is general solution. In exercise 2, 9.2, what it was there? This expression was given to us and differential equation was given to us. We were asked to find out that whether this is the solution of this equation. Yes or no? Same thing is there. There, solution and differential equation both were given to us. In this case, only differential equation is given to us. We need to find the solution. So this is the solution. Right? Okay? Written?
Yeah.
Oh, very good. Can we go to next question?
Yes.
One more question we will be solving. Right. Let us solve question number 4 in this exercise. So that question number 4 is, second square x 10y dx plus second square y 10x dy is equal to 0. Can I rub this side, gentlemen?
Yes.
Okay. Any doubt? Any doubt?
We have to. No.
Okay.
No.
So now in this question, what we will be doing, let us take it one side. So second square y 10x dy, keep it one side. Another one side you take it, second square x 10y dx. It is minus?
Yeah.
Okay. Now you bring here, so second square y dy. Divided by this, 10y we can bring this side.
Okay, 10y.
10y?
Yeah.
Similarly, this side minus second square x by 10x we can bring this side.
Yes.
So this one will become dx. Yes or no? Okay. Now we can go for.
Can the minus be on the other side?
This one minus is there?
Yeah, can the minus go to the other side? Like, what I have done is that I have.
You took this one?
Yeah, taken. No. I took second square.
No problem. Anyone you can take. You took dy portion there. You took this dy portion that side. No problem.
Okay.
Doesn't matter.
No, because I got the minus on the dy side.
Okay, no problem. You, what you do, if I am multiplying with minus. Okay, this side is minus. And this side it is plus. That's all you got it?
Yeah, that's okay.
No problem.
Will happen to answer?
No. No need. Anywhere you can do it. Okay. So this side also you can write this side. This side also you can write this side. Okay. No problem. Now we will go for integrating. Right. So integrating
is
minus.
1 plus 10.
Now, yes. Second square y dy by 10y. Correct?
Or 1.
Is equal to second square x by 10x dx. So it is easy?
Yes.
Substitution?
Yeah.
So 10x is equal to z. So second square x dx is equal to dz. So if you are solving this one, so you are getting log 10x plus c, correct?
Yes.
So that particular formula we will be applying here also. So this one is giving you minus log 10y. Tell me yes or no?
Yes, yes.
Then this side it is log 10x plus, can we write this c as log c?
Log c, yeah.
Log c, log c. Because that is constant only.
Yes, no problem. Like, we have integrated the left side and the right side. And you have taken constant on the right side.
Only one constant will be there.
Okay.
whatever you are doing, only one constant. If you want, you can write here as C1. You can write here as C2. After that, C1, C2, whatever plus minus is there, only one constant will be there. Then after, you can write, no problem.
Okay.
You can take C1 here, you can put C2 here, bring it to one side, make it one C. Okay? So only one constant will be there. So it doesn't matter you are writing C1 here or not, you are writing only one C.
Okay.
It is understood.
Okay.
So very good, you have asked this question. I appreciate, because after every integration one constant should come.
Yes, yes, yes.
So it is good. So here we can write C1 plus C1. Here we can write plus C2.
So log C minus C.
Combining both of them together, only one C will be there afterwards. So you can bring this 10x here. Correct?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So we can write as minus log 10y. Eh?
Yeah.
Minus log 10y is equal to, so you can say log 10x into c.
Into c.
Yeah. Okay. So now we can go for equating both sides.
Okay.
Because log is there. But here,
minus
it will be what? Minus
log.
So 1/10y you can write. 1/10y. So this is given to us as 10x into c is equal to 1/10y.
Yes, sir.
Very good. Right. So this particular part we can write as C is equal to 1/10x and 10y.
Yeah.
1/10x 10y we can write. That also problem is not there. Okay. So the same it will become a solution. Right. Very good.
We define the value of C. Find the value of C.
No. Here we need not to find value of C here.
No, meaning?
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, even if this C is equal to 1/10x 10y, we can write also as 10x. 10y is equal to C also. Why? Because C, 1/C, that also will become C only. So C is equal to 10x 10y also we can write. Even if we are writing this one, then also it is correct. Even if we are writing this one, then also it will be correct. Okay, now C value you will not be able to find because no other condition is given to us.
Yes.
We'll see in some of the questions it will be given to us that this condition is there, then we will be able to find exactly the constant value. That will become particular solution.
Yes, yes, yeah.
Okay,
yes.
That case will be particular solution. Okay?
Yeah.
Right. So let us solve some of the questions.
We have to
terminate
the log in the
certain answer. Not necessary. Okay. Not necessary, but as far as it is possible, you can remove it.
Yeah.
So, how we can remove it? Only when we are taking C as log C.
Yeah. Yes.
If log C you are not taking, simply C you are taking, then you have to keep it as it is. Log 10x log like this.
Yeah.
Then also it is correct.
Okay.
Yes. Then also it is correct. Okay. Now one more question we'll be doing. Can I have it? Yes. And this is question number 11. So what it says, x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Okay, dy by dx is equal to 2x square plus x. 2x square plus x. And here condition is given to us that y is equal to 1 when x equal to 0. When x equal to
0.
It means we need to find particular solution here.
Yes.
Okay?
Yeah.
But before that, same procedure will be there to find general solution.
Yeah.
Okay. So now in this 2x square plus x it is there. And x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Right, very good. So what we'll be doing? So dy is equal to 2x square plus x divided by x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 dx. Yes or no, gentlemen?
Yeah.
Then again integrating both sides, so dy is equal to 2x square plus x by x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 dx. Now please tell me that what you will be doing here by seeing this one.
We will take x cube plus
okay.
x square
right
plus
So let us factorize this first.
Okay.
Let us factorize.
Okay.
We will try to find this factorization. If we will be able to factorize it, then partial fractions that we can use.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. So 100% this type of question, wherever it will be there, it can be factorized.
Okay.
Okay. In examination also, if this type of question is coming, so factorization can be done. So by using remainder theorem, try to factorize it.
Okay.
Okay. So suppose fx is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Okay. Here we will not do. In this side we will be doing. So suppose fx is equal to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Right?
Yes, sir.
Now, trial and error method.
Okay.
Suppose we are putting x is equal to 1. Eh?
Yes.
So, x equal to 1 we should not put. Why? All 1 will come, it will not be 0.
Yeah.
Eh? So, it is general. So, x equal to minus 1 if we are putting.
1 plus 1 minus 1.
X equal to minus 1, then f minus 1.
Minus
1.
Minus
is equal to minus 1.
Plus 1.
Plus 1. Minus 1.
Plus
1.
Plus 1.
0, it means x equal to minus 1 is a factor. What? X plus 1, correct?
Yes, sir.
X plus 1 is equal to 0?
Yeah, yeah.
So x plus 1 is a factor of this polynomial. It means we will be able to factorize it. Okay. So x plus 1 into any polynomial px is equal to this one. X cube plus x square plus x plus 1. It means px is equal to what? X cube plus x square plus x plus 1 divided by x plus 1. Okay. So we can divide it now.
Yeah.
We will go for actual division method.
X square.
X plus 1. So x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. So x square. Very good. So x cube plus x square. Correct. Minus minus. Both cancelled.
Minus x minus
1. Very nice. So we have got minus, sorry, x plus 1, not minus x,
oh,
plus
okay.
If it will be in denominator here, then it will be changed its
yeah.
Okay,
plus
x plus 1 only has come?
Plus 1.
So plus 1,
yeah.
Correct?
Yeah.
So it has become x
zero.
Plus 1, again?
0.
0. So this px is equal to what?
X square plus 1.
Very nice. So it means x plus 1 into x square plus 1 is equal to this polynomial. So it can be factorized very well. So y is equal to 2x square plus x divided by
x
square plus 1 and x plus 1.
Yes.
Yes,
sir.
Yes or no, gentlemen? Okay. So can we use partial fractions now here?
Yes, sir.
Tell me
yeah.
What type of partial fraction you will be using here? Which type
we
of?
We have to use x square plus b square, a square plus b square.
Okay. Right. So because here x square plus 1 is there, that x square plus 1 we cannot factorize further. So ax plus b, that we will be utilizing it.
Okay,
we will be utilizing ax plus b. So you can write here as this 2x square plus x by x square plus 1 and x plus 1 is equal to a by x plus 1 compulsory.
Yes, yes.
No problem.
Yeah.
Another one. For this one, bx plus c by x square plus 1.
Oh, can't we write x square plus 1 as x square plus, plus 1 square?
We cannot write na? X square plus 1 we cannot write. So now this partial factorization has come.
Okay?
So it means 2x square plus x is equal to a into x square plus 1 plus b into x plus 1 plus c x plus y. Now we need to find the value of a, b, c.
Yeah.
Okay. So let us find. So can we put x equal to minus 1?
No.
If we will be putting x equal to minus 1, so this part will become 0.
Yes. Even that.
Due to this one, it will be 0. Yeah. This one also, it will be 0. Okay. Here it will be 2 and minus 1. 2 and minus 1, correct?
A is 1/2.
And here it is minus 1 square, so 1 only, 1 plus 1. So into 2a. 2a, correct?
Yeah, 1/2.
So this is giving you a is equal to
1/2.
Very good. Another one, what we can put it here? X equal to 0. Let us put x equal to 0. Because for plus 1 also, if you are putting that, so a, b, c will come.
Yeah.
So x equal to 0. This part will become 0.
Yeah.
Okay, so here it is 0 only?
0 equal to?
Right, 0 is equal to?
1. A.
A
plus C.
Plus C, very good. A value already is there with us.
Minus 1 by 2.
So you can say C is equal to?
Minus 1 by 2.
Very nice. Let us find the value of?
B.
B now.
So this substitute
so
1.
So B, you want?
This substitute 1.
If you are substituting, put x equal to 1.
1 is it, yeah.
X equal to 1. So x equal to 1. Then 2 plus 1, 3, yeah?
Yes.
Is equal to
2.
Here 1 plus 1, 2.
1.
1 plus 1, 2.
Yeah,
so 2a.
1 by 2, 2 is 1.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, yes,
2a
yeah.
Plus, here 1, so here also 2b.
2b.
Plus 2b.
Minus
plus 2c.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay,
so, three
so 3 is equal to 2
one.
Into 1 by 2,
one.
So 1
plus 2b
plus 2b
minus 1.
Minus 1, very good, minus 1.
So, three
so
by
1 two. And minus 1 will get cancelled?
3 by 2.
So b is equal to?
3 by 2.
3 by 2. Right?
Yes.
So now we can put the value?
Yes.
Here, okay. So you can say that y is equal to a by x plus 1. So a is 1 by 2?
Yeah.
So dx
1 by x plus 1.
By x plus 1. Correct?
Yes.
Plus. B is equal to what? 3 by 2, na?
Yeah.
Okay. So 3 by 2.
2 x
and
plus.
X by x square plus 1. X there?
Yes, yes. So
bx
plus c.
Bx plus c. Huh? So b, x.
Okay, yeah. Yes, yes.
So dx. Plus. Now c
by
is minus 1 by 2.
Minus 1 by 2
and dx
by x square plus 1.
X square plus 1.
Okay.
Yes or no?
Yes.
If it is so,
half
then
of log.
Half.
Log.
Log x plus 1. Very good.
Plus 3 by 2.
Plus. This
log.
One you can substitute.
We can.
X is, due to this x is there, na?
Yeah.
So 2x.
Yeah,
so 2x we have to make it here.
1 by divided.
So 4,
4
3 by 4. 4.
Yeah.
So it will become
3 by 4 log.
3 by 4
log.
Log.
X square plus 1.
X square plus 1. Okay. Then here minus 1 by 2. Tell me x square plus 1 is where? X square plus 1 is square.
Yes,
the formula
yes,
is
yes.
dx by x square plus a square. Is equal to what?
X
1 by a. Tan inverse.
X
by a. Plus c.
Yeah.
That formula?
Yes.
Okay, so a is 1 only.
Yeah, tan is x.
1 by 2. So tan inverse.
X.
Plus
c.
C. Your solution has come out. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now, condition is given. It is general solution.
Yeah.
Particular solution. So y is equal to 1.
1.
When x equal to 0. Okay. So x equal to 0 we have to put here. Y is equal to 1.
And 0.
So 1 is equal to
0.
So log 1.
0.
So this one will become 0.
Zero.
This one also?
0.
0?
Yeah.
So if x equal to 0 log 1. Okay. Tan inverse 0 also 0.
No. Oh, yeah.
Tan inverse 0 is equal to 0. So c is equal to 1 only. Yes or no?
Yes.
So there is not much change. The solution will become what? Y is equal to half log. Oh, in there? Okay, no problem. Half log x plus 1 plus 3 by 4 log x square plus 1 minus half tan inverse x plus 1. That's all. Yes or no?
Yes.
Plus 1. So this is the solution. Right, please note it down.
Yes.